Welcome to the Promotion Studio. Today we're joined by Will Wesley and his band. What's going on, guys?
Hey, how's it going? How you doing? It's good to be here.
Glad to have you guys. You came quite a long way up from Louisiana, Baton Rouge area to be here. So what brings you here today? I mean, you're going to play some music for us, and I'd like you to introduce the guys.
Yeah, man, we're going to be ripping and roaring in a few minutes. We got Mr. Seth Jones here on the drums, Mr. Phil Chandler on the bass.
How's it going?
Yeah, man. Okay, and what kind of music do you guys play? You said you play a lot of kind of country, rock, southern influence stuff.
Yeah, we're definitely southern influence, but we kind of mesh a lot of styles together, man. We do blues, we do classic rock, we do a little bit of everything. You know, more of our original style is more based out of rock country, you know.
Well, that area is steeped in a big history of, you know, it's a melting pot of music for sure down through there. What got you into like playing the blues and rock and kind of putting those genres together?
Yeah, man, I was kind of born into it. My dad was a guitar player, so he like raised me as a blues guitarist, you know. But being a student of music, I always tried to kind of study different styles. And, you know, the older I got, I found that I could make a living better by knowing many different styles of music, you know. So I started kind of combining them together and kind of made a style out of it.
Right on. Yeah. So how did you hook up with these guys?
Well, Seth here was actually a friend of Phil's, which me and Phil are from the same town, you know, and a drummer I had at the time had said, man, you gotta hear this kid on bass, man, he's killer. And I was like, really? So I went and checked him out, and I was like, man, I've got to have this guy in my band, just an enormous talent. And at that time, my drummer had actually moved away, and he introduced me to Seth, and it's been history ever since, man.
So how long have you guys been playing together?
I would say roughly around 2 years.
Just 2 years, really?
We move fast.
All right. And so, like, you guys been in a couple bands before, or you just...
Yeah.
I was actually the front man for my own band called Orange Joe, with which, like, Seth was a crucial member being the drummer. Like, his drumming is part of the sound. It wouldn't sound the same without him. But we had done our musical thing, and I freelance a lot as well, and so does Seth. We all kind of do it just to, you know.
I guess it's just that area,
right? You got to get in the dirt to make money doing music, really. Yeah. But quite frankly, we know how to roll. We're all musicians who can be thrown to the wolves. So when it's something like, hey, we need to do it in this style. We need to do this.
And I love to throw these guys to the wolves, by the way. I'll probably do it today. I'm going to throw you to the wolves today, man.
So you said you got a new album that you're working on, or two albums, technically. It's a double album.
Technically, yeah. We got a double album that we're working on called Both Sides of the Tracks. And what's interesting is it's really going to bring together the styles that I was influenced by growing up. You know, you have a pop country slash classic country side of it. But then you also have other influences on it, like rock, even a hint of punk rock coming through it. So it's kind of going to be an original kind of animal, so to speak.
So are like each disc kind of going to sound different, or is it all going to be like the same?
Yeah, we kind of, on one CD, we've put more of the pop country and the classic country and the rock. And then on the other side, I talk as though it's a record. On the other CD, it's going to be more of the Americana and the bluegrass, like we have.
Right on.
Yeah, dude, we really combine them together, you know.
All right, and you actually have a couple of videos that you're planning as well. You like to script videos.
Yeah. Well, that's kind of one of the things I've always had a passion for, is I write my own scripts in my music videos and things. And I had this really elaborate idea, so to speak. So what I've done is I've created a trilogy of videos that's going to tell a pretty intricate story, and they're going to follow each other. We've already finished the first video for Let It All Burn, and we are already to work on the script and filming the second video, Leah. So it's gonna be pretty interesting for the viewer.
I saw Let It All Burn, and it's great cinematography. I mean, did you storyboard all that in your mind and just kind of find the director to work for it?
Well, you know, I've had a guy named J.B. Lawrence who's worked with me for a long time on my videos. I'm kind of particular who I like behind the camera, and J.B. has always been pretty masterful at that. And you know, I kind of like to get the right team of people around me when I write my script who can bring the story to life. And JB is the perfect guy for that. He's very well respected and a very good director.
So writing music, is it kind of a collaborative effort, or you just kind of bring a song to the table and then kind of...
The way it is, man, is I'm kind of an idea man in a sense. You know, I write songs fluently. But this guy back here, produces all my material. So what he does is he kind of helps me refine it, break it down.
Yeah.
You know, change this, change that. So I guess I'd have to say Phil's not only my producer, but also my co-writer as well. You know, so kind of a team unit there.
So what's it like, the trio dynamic? Any interesting road stories? Any bad things happen out on the show? Good things happen at the show?
Yeah, we definitely got some pretty interesting stories, you know. But I think if I was really to like just break it down, man, I would say that it's just an experience traveling across the world, going to Europe and going to all these places, and seeing how people live in different states and in different cultures. It's always been inspiring to me to see that. You know, it's kind of what drives me. It's what I do. You know?
With the touring experience, where's been some of the favorite places you've been?
I think I'd have to say like Bern, Switzerland, right, or Lucerne, Switzerland. You know, I've going to Europe was really a highlight of my plans so far, just because I really love their appreciation for music there.
Absolutely.
I love how, like, you know what I'm saying, man. Here in the States, you know, you can play and everyone is just, they're cool. But overseas, everyone's quiet. They sit down. They appreciate you. It's very different. It kind of trips you out when you're first starting.
It's a different culture for sure. You do have, like, the bar bands that play down there to a rowdy crowd, but people are still engaged in a different way than I feel like they are here.
I couldn't agree more.
Did you try to pick up the language at all any place that you've gone?
I'm not very good at picking up languages. Not just joking. No, man. I try to learn a little bit from everywhere I go.
Yeah, I mean, you gotta be at least conversational. You know?
Yeah, you gotta be able to hold a conversation.
Yeah, ask somebody for a drink or, you know.
Yeah, you can't just play guitar over everything.
I need directions back to my room. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Talk to the ladies.
Yeah.
You gotta be able to relay the directions back to
the ladies. Absolutely. So, thanks a lot for being here. When do you expect the new album to be out?
You know, we're gonna be releasing it in halves. So, we're gonna release the first CD in the next 2 months.
Okay.
And then we're probably going to follow it up in the summer with the second half of the CD.
And it's both sides of the tracks?
Both sides of the tracks.
All right. So you're going to be able to pick up the first one maybe within the next 2 months. Keep an eye out for that. And then its companion dropping a few months later. Will Wesley Band. You can check them out online. Get all the music wherever you download music. Amazon, Google Play, Spotify, all of that. Go listen. Check out the videos as well. Great videos. Guys, thanks so much for stopping by.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
All right, and don't forget to like, comment, subscribe down below. That way you don't miss another Promotion Live session.